So, you know how to draw, but you don't know what to draw. Not a problem. Now, I've done a lot of research regarding what and where the pros tend to make their detail. Essentially, there's two types of techniques for detail: biological detail and mechanical. Today, we'll focus on biological. So, the kind of stuff that you would draw on top of people, skin, and clothing. And the answer is actually pretty simple. Remember, the people who created this art style were also the same people who created BlazBlue. So, a lot of the team had a background in 2D art first. So, it should be no surprise when you realize that the type of detail that you put on your texture map should actually be the same type of detail that you would expect to see on a 2D manga. Hatches. Hatching is a technique as old as time. Traditionally, it's mainly used for shadows, but in anime, it's often used to add some texture to empty space. Here's an example of a work without hatching. Now here's what that same work looks like with it. You see how the small little hatch scratches give a better sense of texture? That's really it. Keep it simple. You should not add too much detail onto your AO. So that's what you draw, but where do you draw it? Well, if you pay close attention to the professionals, they use it in two different ways. One, to fill up empty space like we said before. And two, on the edges of your seams. Now, my theory is the main reason they put most of their hatches on the edges is because when you square the UVs, that's where the detail is most reliably clear. You'll notice the closer to the walls of the seam, the more straight the lines become. But if you try and draw lines towards the middle of the object, the lines may start to bend and distort due to the way we stretched it into a square. So, those are the main strategies when it comes to adding detail to biological objects. Hope that helps, and as always, hope you have a fantastic day, and I'll see you around. We'll